Hey guys, it's your Barker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chrome World last time off. I had a bit of a bizarre game, a crazy game against in the first leg. Hey, good. In my first knockout stage game of the Champions League with Liverpool against Juventus. If you didn't see that match, go back and watch it. And the crazy stuff in this career mode, oh, it continues. Who's but hopefully not crazy he matches on the pitch. It's a crazy schedule. This is the League Cup final. Oh, ironically, it's against Hull. Who, while it's unlikely, this could still technically be the final in real life. Hull are going to have to overcome Manchester United's 2-0 win in the first leg, though, which I can't see them doing. And Liverpool will have to overcome Southampton's 1-0 win for us in the earlier this week. But, all in all, this could... There is a slim possibility, but this could still be the real-life final. It's probably going to be Manchester United and Southampton, considering the form Liverpool have been on lately. Which is, terrible. Well, thank you, 2017. I thought that you were going to leave us from the horrors of 2016. But, oh no, Liverpool! We'll decide this is going to be the year we're up to shit. Apparently. Because...
room for a shot, maybe.
We've had... two draws and a loss. We're 3 games, 14 days. Well, it's not 14 days when you're seeing this. You're seeing this on Thursday. But I'm recording this on Saturday. And so, right now it's the 14th. So, by the time you see this, Liverpool will have played against Manchester United. Hopefully, I say hopefully, really hopefully, Liverpool will have a win in 2017 by now, but I'm not going to get my hopes up, especially not against Manchester United. Because if Mourinho doesn't think that United can beat Liverpool, he's going to park his fucking little bus. Because except for his ego, everything else about Mourinho is fucking small. You can just tell by the way he carries himself.
He's coming forward with some danger.
And, yeah, when he parks that bus, Liverpool won't be able to get past it, and it'll be another fucking nil-all draw, just like it was at Anfield. But, considering it's at Old Trafford, I think they will go for it a bit. But they'll only probably go for one goal, and they'll say, oh, okay, that's enough. That's enough.
Great stop.
That's enough. Let's park the bus. Let's go.
It's a big moment for them in the match.
Go into ultimate defense mode and fucking just watch Liverpool get frustrated as they can't break it down.
We expect it to be better than the opposition. That's the way it's panning out so far.
Yeah, you'd expect them to ease away from the opposition in this match. Can't see any shocks in it. I can't really.
Just worried about the rain only in that it's impairing a bit up.
So, yeah, frustration is probably inbound tomorrow when I'm recording this. Of course, it has already happened by the time you're watching this, so... if the result was good, you're probably sitting there thinking, he was worried over nothing. And if it was bad, you're probably saying to yourself, oh, he was spot on. Now maybe Manchester United will go for more than one goal. Well, if they do go for any at all.
But not to the collection there.
But if they do win, I'd say it'll be by one goal. I say they'll snake a goal late in the game. Or they'll get an early goal because Liverpool will be bombing forward, trying to break United. Maybe eat early before they really get settled. Well, United will catch just out and they'll get the early goal. And either way, United would win. If they don't snake that goal or get the early goal, then it'll end up a 0-0 draw. Now, I want to believe that Liverpool could actually get something from this match, but considering their 2017 form so far, and the fact that you don't seem to care to play again. Well, no, it's not even Manchester United. It's Mourinho. He's shitting himself with Liverpool. He came up with, and everyone who I've heard a lot of people will complain when people go park the bus like against them on FIFA. You know who's to blame? That little prick, that Portuguese prick that's in charge of Manchester United. That's who you blame. Don't blame FIFA. EA added Park the Bus because they saw it used by Mourinho when he was in charge of Chelsea. In the game that Gerrard slipped. Chelsea were parked. Liverpool were trying to break him down. And after the Gerrard slip, Chelsea got away with him. Counter-attack. They got in on goal. They scored. And the rest, they say, is history. But it's not. Especially not to Manchester United fans and Chelsea fans. Who won't stop fucking laughing about it. And now they're just, Mourinho's just like, oh, Liverpool are in town, or we're going to Liverpool. Fucking, fuel up the bus. Fuel up the bus.
Came close to goalkeeper, actually did.
That's all we needed. Fucking fuel up the bus. And watch.
Well beaten, really.
Instead of playing real football and having a real game, do your cheap fucking little shitty tactic.
Grabs here.
Fucking joke.
We've reached the hour mark. Half an hour to go. I spotted the pass and cut it out. Opportunity here. Well, they almost got another goal here.
Emery, what was that? How did that not go in? Maybe I was too close. I was trying to chip it, just dink it over Heaton. For 4-0. And it didn't come off as planned. There we go. Emery Moore. A nice little finish. Thank you very much.
And they've got themselves a goal well out of the keeper's reach.
The League Cup is secure for a second season running. Very nice. Six goals in the competition. I think that makes him the top goal scorer.
Curtis Davis. Oscar Trejo.
Actually, I think his first goal made him the top goal scorer. Or him, and then Alexander Arnold were both on 4. Che Ojo was on 3, and he does score the goal, so he would have leveled with Alexander Arnold. But it looks like Moore is taking the top goal scorer award for the this year's League Cup season's League Cup, I should say, not this year's.
Gets his foot in there. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. Any danger to the goal has gone with that clearance.
Substitution for Hull City.
Divock Origi. The cross coming in. Very straightforward save.
That was a terrible cross. That was on my part. My bad.
Ten minutes left of regular time. Livermore. Now it goes into
so, the yeah.
Where they've got a winger waiting. Defender to it first. Origi.
You're right. Doom and gloom is probably coming. Tomorrow morning. This is recorded, of course, this is Sunday was a few days ago when you're actually seeing this on Thursday. But, you know, I can't talk about a game that hasn't happened yet. No. The video you saw on Tuesday went up after the match. Just, you know, the game, but it was recorded on Friday.
Nicely worked until that point.
You're probably saying, why was that one recorded on Friday? This one is being recorded on that's because I had things to do on Friday. So I just needed to record this video today, along with the secondary promo videos that you will be seeing. Oh, secondary promo videos will go up today, tomorrow. No, wait, Liverpool are Monday and Wednesday, sorry. This is Wednesday's video, sorry. It's Tuesday and Thursday for the secondary promo. My bad. Oh, no, I just want to mention something. Some people, I got asked by a friend on Twitter when I would be doing the season 3 of The Walking Dead, because I played through season 1 and 2. I'm not the biggest fan of season 3, but I am gonna play it. There will be a playthrough. Although, I'm pissed off that Clementine isn't the main character anymore. Fucking hell, Telltale. You know, you have a perfectly good main character, and then you replace her with some random dude who no one gives a shit about. And anyone who says they do, you're obviously not a true fan of the game. Because Clementine, if you played season 1 and 2, you should be absolutely furious that they replaced Clementine. And I don't count playing as her in fucking shitty flashbacks. They don't count, you fucking idiots. Imbeciles. Seriously. You have perfect. The game was perfect. When I first saw the trailer for the season 3, I saw Clem with this guy. I didn't realize it was the same guy when I started playing. I was like, Oh. Clem is with another group. Brilliant. So, what was the actual point of having her go off on her own? You know, why can't she be on her own all the time? I mean, she got rid of an idiot child that was just gonna get her fucking killed. So that was one good thing she did. And no, I don't give a shit about AJ. I don't care. He is useless. He can't hold a gun. He can't aim a gun. And all he would do would be cry. But what that would do? It would attract fucking walkers. Which would end up getting Clementine killed. So, you know, for those of you who were sitting there saying, but he's a baby. I don't give a fucking shit if he's a baby. He all the more reason why he fucking, Alvin and whatever that fucking bitch's name was, I can't even remember. They shouldn't have had a child in the fucking apocalypse. You fucking imbecile. If she hadn't died in childbirth, or the second that AJ popped out, was her death sentence. Even if she had lived, she would have died. Guaranteed. Because if she had lived, she would be the one with the baby. And the walkers would be attracted to her. Her. AKA, she would be dead. So, getting rid of AJ, I don't know. We still don't know what happened to him. But thankfully, he's gone. Hopefully, he's not coming back. But with the way the first two episodes have gone, I'm not sure. He might be in with the New Frontier. That might be where he is. The New Frontier might be fucking raising him. I hope to Christ that's not the case, but I have to wait till episode 3 comes out to find out more. And what the hell... Oh, great Javi. How great is Javi? Fucking Javi, his dumbass brother, is leading the New Frontier and shot his own kid! He shot her! If Javi is sensible, the first thing that will happen when episode 3 starts up, Javi will go up and punch David straight in the fucking face and your men killed your daughter. How do you feel? Oh, where the fuck have you been? And your daughter's dead, and it's your own fault. Oh, you're a fucking imbecile. Thank you. Welcome back. Right. Can we go back to Clementine, please? I don't know why I'm so... Actually, I know full well I'm pissed off about this, because it's bullshit.
Wholesale changes for Chelsea. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. Branislav Ivanovic starts with Azpilicueta.
So, yeah, season three. I was thinking of the show. I was almost gonna say season 6. I was like, what season is it? I know I haven't watched the season of the show, but I know it's in like something like season whatever.
Sturridge, and the goalkeeper has done well.
But I will do a playthrough. I will do videos on season 3, but I want to play through the full thing first once, and I want to wait till the full thing is out, because it's better to wait until the full thing is out, because if you were waiting on videos on, you know, people, if my comments were enabled, well, and I started, you know, recording in episode,
but of course they're a fair way away from home.
Yeah, they are, and you know, as we know, psychologically it has an effect, so we'll see if they can cope with that today.
I record episode 1 of season 3 and episode 2. I'll be waiting for episode 3. I don't know when episode 3 is even coming out. I'm assuming it's soon, but, you know, it's fucking taking its time. Oh, how close can you get?
Good through ball.
Alaba against Ivanovic. One winner there. Alaba! Oh, penalty! Perfect. Damn it. Perfect, damn it. The man who won it is the penalty taker, Ivanovic. He was not happy that Alaba got past him with ease. And he was like, this shit heads. He gone now. Oh, Courtois probably should have denied Alaba his. But David Alaba scores his 9th goal of the season. And he is still 100% on penalties at Liverpool. Oh, somehow. Look at this. Oh, Courtois. Super unlucky. Ivanovic has his head in his hands because he's realized he's completely fucked up. That's 1-0. That was a mad sequence of events. That leads to the opening goal of this crucial fixture.
Attacking well here. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball.
Alaba again! Oh, and Firmino! What was that? It looked like he was trying to do a fucking bicycle kick, but he said fuck it halfway through and said, I'll do it fucking. I won't even fucking jump in the air, I'll just. Oop. What the fuck was that? I've never seen. That's almost like half a bicycle kick, half a scorpion kick, but he did it in a totally different way to Olivier Giroud. What the fuck was that? What do I even call that? What was it? Is it a back heel goal? Does it technically count as a bicycle kick? What the fuck? What do I call that? Yes.
Strong challenge. Could be dangerous.
Maybe I'll call it the bicycle scorpion goal. Oh. Well, people will be so fucking confused. They'll be like, wait, what?
Well, in the clear, and he's made a total hash of it.
Just panicked, I think. He lost his nerve at the vital moment.
This is a team on top of its game. It's certainly been reflected in the results.
Coutinho. They want to extend. Ivanovic again! What is he doing? He's giving away another penalty! What has he done?
Lost the composure, haven't they? It's been a poor day.
Ivanovic has given away a second penalty! Come on, he has to get yellow this time, right? He's knocking a yellow! That is definitely a yellow card! I mean, I don't think it's a red card offense, but it's definitely a yellow card offense. It's not a red card offense because it wasn't a goal scoring opportunity. The Alaba again scores from the spot. This time Courtois is rude to the spot. He doesn't know what to do anymore. Her David Alaba goes to double figures, most of which were penalties. So the white line from the free kick a few minutes ago is still there. Just the beautiful penalty. A brace from David Alaba, and a Roberto Firmino, super goal of some description. Ivanovic is a lucky, lucky boy. He might be dropped after this by Conte, but right now he is
Chelsea attacking here. Cross coming in now. Not a great cross.
He's very lucky to have escaped two penalty decisions. The first one, I guess the first one, you know, you could say, okay, hey, leave him off for that one. But the second one, how did he not get a yellow card for that?
Equator. And the referee has signaled for half time. 3-0 is the scoreline at this point.
If I don't know if you guys noticed, Ivanovic almost looked over to the touchline is to say, oh shit, I have to go into the dressing room now. After conceding two penalties, he somehow escaped the second one without a yellow card. He might not be coming back out in the second half. Arsenal are taking advantage. Swansea are holding them, which is good. Keep doing that, Swansea. Keep doing that. And I'll, think of something. I'll have to reward you for Swansea. But, keep that up. Daniel Sturridge has a goal against his former club just to add insult to injury. He reaches the monumental 31.
The situation for them should be home and hosed.
Let's see the replay now.
Sadio Mane is still waiting on one goal to break his record of 35 goals from last season. Daniel Sturridge equals the old record. Heard of 31.
Well, the home team has been outplayed, and the
maybe Daniel Sturridge can take the top spot. He's only 4 goals behind Mane and 5 off the record.
Here's a chance to attack.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well,
Sturridge again! Oh, I didn't catch it as I would have wanted to. Ivanovic gives it away. Sadio Mane for the record. Oh, he didn't break his own record. There it goes, narrowly wide of the post. I don't know what was Martinez doing. He might have put that into his own net if he made any kind of contact on it. Or it might have bounced off of Courtois' legs and just bounced to a. Sadio Mane anyway.
Chelsea, they'll be facing Everton away from home.
It is not Ivanovic's day. It's past the Willian is offside. It is just not his day, is it? No. No is the answer there.
Coming forward with some danger.
Coutinho! Good save from Courtois.
Here we'll see what they can manage from the corner.
Good strong hand from the goalkeeper.
Well, he's pressed him there to run.
That's a goal kick. John Matip couldn't get it out of his feet.
About Liverpool's next game.
To who?
Well, they're playing Norwich City, aren't they, in their next match? And the way that they're playing,
what was that?
They'll win it pretty comfortably.
No, seriously, what was that?
Well, when they do say, have you been in these matches about...
I'm trying to process what I saw, but I don't know what I saw. Oh! Say I'm ready, though, sorry.
He goes a bit early, gets a bit too eager.
Yeah, he's a good bit offside.
Building steadily here, keeping possession. He's got the ball away from the danger momentarily, but it is a corner following that good tackle. Hasn't threatened, has he, the great Lewandowski?
Well, the defenders will be pleased to see of shot success or lack of.
He's got his shot off.
Sewell! Oh! He did win another corner. So there is that. Matip! Oh! Not on this occasion. And Vrain just came on. I didn't see who he came on for. Did he replace Ivanovic? Is Ivanovic's worst day ever finally over. It looks like it is.
Just over a quarter an hour left.
I can actually make my own substitutions while I am changing these around. I don't want to just... Oops, why are they switched around? That's hot. I want to check, because I didn't pay any attention to who went off. It was Banasanovic. His terrible day of giving away two free kicks, passing to an offside player. Just in general, probably the worst game he's ever played in his professional career. And Antonio Conte is like, yeah, this is well over. Oh, but he's missed a historic moment as Sadio Mane breaks his own Premier League record and makes the record 36 goals in one season from the same player. Gota is unfortunately part of this history, as it's the ball goes past him into the net over the line. Eighth minute, and Sadio Mane has broken his own record with plenty of games to spare. Sadio Mane's
being replaced now. Manages.
He still has a really good chance of reaching that elusive 40 goals.
He's into the box. His opponent just couldn't keep up. If you're losing count, it's 5-0. We've got 10 minutes left on the clock.
Not bad for someone who's only 82 rated. I mean, the lowest rated player in my team, and he is always on the best form. Where is the logic, EA? Oh, he might score again! Oh, he almost scored again. De Hood will score, though. Oh, Chelsea are just being absolutely annihilated. De Hood is getting in on the act. Heck, he is excited because he knows the title will be in his hands before he knows it. It was actually his pass to Mane. So, inadvertently, it was a... But, not quite a 1-2 pass because Mane didn't directly give it back to De Hoop, but it found its way back to him and he stuck it home. And it's not a good day to be a Chelsea fan or a Chelsea manager or anyone associated with Chelsea.
Rafael Varane.
And this is the bridge. This is not Anfield. This is Stamford Bridge. This is an away game. And I have ripped Chelsea to absolute sunders. This is first versus second. You wouldn't know it. This is why I say there is no title race. It's because this is my closest rival. These guys. Unless Arsenal have beaten Swansea, in which case Arsenal will be in second place. He's only with a window, which is why I was telling Swansea to hold on to that draw. Maybe they've done me one better and picked up the win, but I'm not going to hold my breath for that. Although, it's also been really going my way. He's over this season, so... it's not completely out of the question. David Alaba continues his 100% record on penalties. He probably should have lost it on the first one. The second one, there was no question about. He stuck it home. Bamic should have gotten a yellow card for it. Courtois, as miserable day is over. Ivanovic was spared 15 minutes of or so misery. It was just bad. It was a bad day at the office for Chelsea. Wait, hey, Swansea did hold on. So Chelsea, he's looking the bright side of that they are still in second place. But on the on the other hand, they are 29 points behind with 12 games remaining, which is a grand total of 36 points.
West Ham United 1, Bournemouth 1.
You are most welcome, Phil, and you played very well. Well, good job about that.
In second, Chelsea with 49.
So, if you do the math,
in fourth, rising up the table are Crystal Palace with.
It's not long in coming.
Moving down are Manchester United with 46 points. In sixth,
It is not far away.
In seventh and falling are Leicester City with 36 points. In eighth, rising up the table are.
Three or four more league wins will win me the Premier League title. You're both welcome. And hey, another match is coming up for one of you. It'll probably be LeBlanc. Alright, two more matches is coming up for him. Well, LeBlanc will probably only play one of those, and Grouch will play the other. But there you see. Those. Unless results go against me, he will win the Premier League. At the latest, probably Hull, or maybe Brighton. I should win it before I play Hull. It should be one before Hull. It might be one before I play Brighton, if Chelsea he keep dropping points and Arsenal keep dropping points. Manchester United are another one who could drop more points. Same with Palace. I'm 41 points ahead of Spurs, so I have definitely guaranteed I'm finishing in the top five. How are Spurs not? They're 9 points behind Manchester United. Jesus. The top five, the second to fifth, is so tight. There's only a point between each of them. Chelsea are a point above Arsenal. Arsenal are another point above Palace, below them in fourth. And Palace in fourth are a point above United in fifth. What the fuck? It's so close. And then to me, 78 points from 49. There is no title race. And soon it will be, it like Ivanovic's day will reach its merciful end. Until, and thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.